Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. I'd like to welcome you to this performance. My name is Sean. And I would like to say a few words on my behalf. The piece I played for you just now was written by Frédéric Chopin. He was a Polish composer. He plays it, yeah, very well. Yes. No, it's very interesting because, you know, he plays the piano on his own, or he learned on his own. He was almost self-taught. In fact, his only teacher was a violin teacher. Yeah. But anyways, that's it. I would like to dedicate this next number to those of you in the audience who appreciate the music of dead piano composers. This next piece was written by Beethoven. No, Beethoven was a German composer. As a matter of fact, he was born in Germany. In a barn, Germany, to be exact. In like the auto barn, Germany. Now, I chose to play this piece tonight because, if you notice, it's quite... after this piece, the intermission happens, and that means I don't have to play anymore in the first half. So, no, I'm just kidding. I like this piece. There are three sections of music you will hear, and they are called movements. And now the first movement is slow, and then fast, and then slow, and then fast again, but then slower, and then and so on and so forth. The name of this particular piano sonata is called the Pathetic Sonata. It was named that because people used to understand the word pathetic to mean evoking emotion. So you will have many different emotions during this piece, one of which being sadness and pain and anger, you get it. In 1798, oh, upside down here, 1798, Beethoven wrote this piece, and he started losing his hearing. So as a writer of music, I'm sure you could be a little sad when you realize you're losing your hearing, knowing that one day you might wake up totally deaf, which he did. The second movement in the chord is quite slow, where Beethoven seems to reflect on his life so far and feeling some nostalgia for the past. The third movement is fast but delicate. You might enjoy it, you might not. So here is the pathetic sonata by Beethoven. Be sure to help yourselves to refreshments after, as I know you are working very hard to sit quietly.
Thank you.
This is now the intermission. You may stand up. I want to know. To introduce you to my brother, Noah. Give him a round of applause. He's very shy. Let's stand up. So, he is going to sing a song tonight. But if you notice, he does not look very German. So he's going to sing a song in Spanish instead. Not that he looks Spanish, but this song is called Quizás, Quizás, Quizás. I wonder what it's about. Well, I will move the microphone. Thank you. I said, some people's children. Okay. I'm going to play another piece. Thank you. forgot to turn the microphone off. Thank you very much. Now that was Franz Schubert, who, if you noticed, has a very German-sounding name. But don't be fooled, he was only Austrian. Like Herr Mozart. And he actually, believe it or not, he never really performed in public for people professionally. He was not a very gifted piano player. But anyhow, he wrote a lot of music. You know, it's interesting because this piece is very important to me, it's the one I just played. Yeah, because I learned it when I was very young, 21, 22 months old. And, you know, the music is very important to people at that age. It's very important. Now, I'd like to dedicate this next number to those of you in the audience who, during the Beethoven, decided not to sow the rotten tomatoes at the piano. I do appreciate that decision. So this one is for you if you had that decision. It is a very lyrical piece. As a matter of fact, it's a lyrical piece for piano. It was written for piano. Kozenko was a Ukrainian composer. And I only know that because he was raised in Ukraine, so yeah. Here's Viktor Kozenko's Gavotte in B minor. And a Gavotte is a type of stylistic dance. It's very short. Now, before we end tonight's concert, I would like to thank you again for coming out tonight and supporting yourselves on those hardwood chairs. I know that they can be uncomfortable. So, anyways, that being said, this final piece is dedicated to the piano tuner, who naturally in tunes the piano. It's good to have an in tune piano, you know, because as a vice, it's not in tune. Composed, this next piece was composed by Franz Liszt, who, if you notice, it sounds like a German name. But don't be fooled, he is not German, he is actually Hungarian. He's from Hungary. It's a very flashy piece, and I listened, which is very difficult to play, which is why I have decided I'm not going to play it. No, I'm kidding. No, it's very complicated, but I'll do my best. Here is La Campanella, which means the bells. Thank you again for coming up.
thank you guys for coming out. I think that was one of the heck of a concert. If I had half that sound. Some people asked if there was a way to give money. There's a cash app that we've got for our Priesthood for Music Fund. On the synopsis of tonight, we mentioned that the donations would go towards our piano laboratory for piano instruction. Actually, that was funded. So we have that in the mail. It's headed towards us. And at the Priesthood High School, we'll be offering piano instruction for anyone that's in.